Hello friends, today I am going to start the lecture on transmission line and waveguides basic. So these are the 5 points which I am going to cover in my this lecture. Total 2 to 3 lectures I will take to cover these 5 points. So topics to be covered are, first I will discuss about the lumped and distributed elements. Okay, what are the difference between lumped and distributed network with respect to the transmission line. Then I will discuss the types of transmission line. Third point, I will be discussing about the transit time effect. When we will talk about the high frequency in the transmission line, then we should consider the transit time effect. So I will derive the relation and I will tell you that what is the effect and when we can ignore this effect in case of transmission line. Then the fourth point, I will cover the primary constant of the transmission line. So this resistance R, inductance L, conductance G and the capacitance C, these all we will consider as a per unit length constants. Okay, so these four will be called as a primary constant. Then based on these four, we will derive again the secondary constants gamma and Z. Gamma is the propagation constant and Z is the characteristic impedance. So these two we will derive. So when we know the primary constant and secondary constant, we can derive the parameters and we can define the transmission line. Okay, so here I am going to start the introduction. Transmission line is a combination of one or more than one conductor which carries the electrical signal. Okay, so here I have written the definition, combination of one or more than one. It means any transmission line, it needs one conductor or two conductor or more than two conductor to carry the electrical signal. And why we need the transmission line? Because this generating signal is far away from the load. Load can be like in the remote location, like our household or any other supplies requirement. Okay, so you can see here the diagram. Like, see here I am using a transmission line. This is the generating station and this side is the load, which is in remote location. So when we are generating the signal, it is always like far away, but we need this electrical signal, okay, to deliver in a whole household supplies or some other places. So we need a transmission line so that we can transmit this electrical signal from this point to this point. Okay, and here we are going to define the properties, all those things, transit effect, primary constant, secondary constant, and the types of what kind of transmission line we can use. So basically transmission line can be made using different type of conducting material like copper, silver, gold, aluminium, all those things we know. But mostly aluminium is preferred over other conductors due to its low cost and low weight. Because density is low, that's why we can consider it as a low weight material. So generally we use aluminium to construct the transmission line. Okay, so now here we are going to discuss the lumped and distributed network. When the primary constants R, L, C and G can be separated as a lumped network, or those elements are called as a lumped element. So when we are using this lumped element and constructing the network, like if I'll tell you the circuit theory, or you know that like BJT and all those things, at low frequencies easily we can separate the resistance, inductance and capacitance and all. But when we cannot separate, where R, L, G and C cannot be separated, then it is called as a distributed element. Okay, so in case of transmission line, as you can see here, transmission line is a distributed network. You can see the down figure, this is two wire transmission line. Okay, so this transmission line is converted into equivalent circuit. If you draw the equivalent circuit of the transmission line, here we have L, R, G and C. Okay, so this can be considered as a one section. So whole transmission line can be divided into multiple section of the L, R, G and C combination. Now the question comes, how inductance, resistance, conductance and capacitance occur? Any two conductor separated with a small distance, whether material is air, free space or anything, if these two wire separated, then it will have a capacitance. Okay, some charge storage capacity is there, so that's why it is represented as a capacitor. Now if any signal flows through the wire, it surrounds some magnetic field that is denoted by the inductance, and between these two wire there will be certain leakage that is represented by the conductance G, and there will be certain loss in the transmission line that is represented by R. So why it is called as a distributed network? Because we cannot remove the L, R, G and C. Okay, these, but still this transmission line is having the property of inductance, resistance, conductance and capacitance. That's why this is called as a distributed network. So over the distance, these all parameters are distributed. Okay, and this is an equivalent circuit. Now, so transmission line is a distributed network. So figure 1, as I shown, which is a lumped equivalent of the transmission line. Okay, components are lumped, but it is distributed across the transmission line. That's why it is called as a distributed network. Another case, if loss is not there, it means in the transmission line, what we have seen here, in this, these two parameters R and G, these two can be ignored if loss is minimal or almost negligible. Okay, if these two are zero, then the transmission line will be drawn as this way, combination of L and C. Okay, R and G is zero. Okay, so this type of transmission line is called as a lossless transmission line. Okay, which is a part of the transmission line, another type. Okay, this type of transmission line is called as a lossless transmission line. Here R is zero and conductance is zero, means series resistance will be zero, there will be negligible loss in the transmission line, and in between these two, leakage current is also zero, so shunt resistance will be infinity. Okay, shunt resistance will be infinity or conductance will be zero. So these two is zero, then we can represent like this, my transmission line will be this. Okay, now I'll show you another property of this one. L, reactance of the L is j omega L, and reactance of the capacitance is 1 by j omega C. So if we are considering the low frequency, means F is 0, okay, then inductance will be short circuited and capacitance will be open circuited. Clear? L will be short circuited, j omega L, okay, and X is 1 by j omega C. So inductance will be short circuited and capacitance will be open circuited. So any signal passes through, so transmission line will be converted into short and open circuit. L is short here and C is open. L is short, C is open. So this way, infinite number of loop will be there. So we can see directly signal, whatever signal we are giving here at the input, it will reach to the output without any disturbance. So low frequency signal can be transmitted easily. But if we'll consider the case of high frequency, at high frequency, inductance will be open circuit and capacitance will be short circuited. So first, in the first stage itself, when L is open here, inductance is open, at high frequency, there won't be any signal. Okay, we cannot pass the signal from input to output. Even though it's small, if we'll reduce little frequency and we'll have a little reactance here, even though it is getting short circuited, again here we'll find out the open circuit. Okay, means a small short circuit. This one is open and this one is short. Even though this is short, we will not get any signal because this is open. Even if it is short circuited, then all the signal will pass through this small reactance. Okay, open circuit means high reactance. So at high frequency, we can see there is no signal passing from input to output. That's why transmission line is also called a low pass filter. Thank you.